Well, there's my hinge. This is how I had to mount it so I can open it and then open the door. And I didn't make the inside too small. What I did was raise the bottom of it 4 inches, which really removed a whole bunch of cubic inches that this thing would need to heat up. And if it still doesn't heat up, I'm gonna bring the back in the same amount, 4 inches. But I've had this out here now for about 30 minutes. And what is that up to? That's about 2 1/4. And that's not bad for just 30 minutes. So I'm gonna adjust this a couple of times over the next hour. And I'll show you what the final temperature is. All right, it's been about an hour. And that is officially the hottest I've ever got this, 275. I'm thinking I still may need to fill the back of this thing in a few inches. That's a whole lot of cubic inches to heat up for no reason. I'm beginning to understand that when you build a solar oven, it just doesn't make any sense to build it any bigger than your pot, you know? Just the size to get whatever you're going to cook in there, and that's it. But I want to make this work. I'm pretty sure I can get up to 300. And if I close that back in, bring it in 4.5 inches like I did the bottom, I think it'll be satisfactory. I have a friend who's made a solar oven, and his solar oven has got the highest temperature achieved so far on YouTube. And if you want to see that, it's JWWM2, and I've got his channel featured on my YouTube homepage there. If you just look down on the right, lower right, you can click on that and go right to his channel. So I'll try this in another hour and see what we've gotten up to, and that'll be about 2.5 hours out here. Surely it'll be as high as it'll get by then. Yeah, we're at 300. If this didn't get any hotter than that, I could live with that. I sort of neglected this. I didn't come out and adjust it and to the sun, you know, and it was way off. So I'm gonna give it a half an hour and check it one more time, because it might have got hotter than that while I was gone. I was in there on the computer. You know how you get lost sometimes and lose track of time. So this time I'm gonna be diligent. I'm gonna come back in exactly a half an hour, and that ought to be about as high as it'll get. All right, one more clip. Well, it's just a tick over 300, like maybe 305, maybe 310. And I'm gonna stop the test. I'm happy with 300. I don't know what happened. I just cut it off by mistake. I'm happy with 300. I can cook pretty much anything I want to at 300 degrees. If it ever does get hotter than that, I'll be sure to let you know. And I may actually cook something in it tomorrow. And now I'm going to put this video up. And then I'm going to sit down. I'm going to tell you a very long, very bizarre story, including my getting fired. Never been fired in my entire life. But that story's coming up. Look for it soon at a newsstand near you. Well, I thought I'd check it one more time. And it's actually... about 325 or so, but look at this. My glass cracked. And it's the inside piece. I mean, it cracked a lot. So I'm gonna have to remove that. And I bought these, they're supposed to be tempered. Oh well.